Can we please welcome to the stage Caoimhín of Fearghail, Dónal Clancy and Paddy Tutty.
How's everyone doing? Are you in good form? Good. We're going to play a few tunes here and we might sing a few songs. Well, I won't, but Dónal here might sing a song for you if you ask him nicely. We might start off with a couple of reels. Ambrose Maloney's and Support from America, number one. And the second tune is a Charlie Lennon tune. So I hope you enjoy these.
Continue with a couple of jigs now, and these two jigs were written by a good friend of ours, passed away near, I suppose, a year and a half ago. John Dwyer, great fiddle player. Used to meet up with him every so often. Like, he'd be playing sessions in Waterford City, and he'd come down to Ring as well, or Dungarvan, if there was any tune. He'd drive home at the age of 80 years or 80 more. Yeah. Great man, and a great composer of tunes, and gentleman. So the first one's called The Sunny Hills of Beara, and the second one is called The Fox in the Thatch. And I think he wrote it for Adele Fox, the concertina player. They used to play in a pub called The Thatch outside Waterford City. So, yeah.
He was a guard one time, John. Yeah. He was a guard in Ring in County Waterford, where Caoimhín and I live. And he used to be up in the session in Mooney's pub until all hours. And then he'd go home and put on the uniform and come back. I'd say, come on now, lads. And then more often than not, he'd sit in again and play away with the uniform on him. Back in the good old days.
Thanks very much. We're going to go to a brother of John's now Finbar. And these two tunes are, I'm looking down at my list here now because I wouldn't be the best at remembering tunes. Hill 60 and The Spring Well. So we'll give these a go. These are quite different, but you'll see. There's a kind of a resemblance there as well between the two brothers, but we'll give them a go.
More of a fiddle show.
Chance a bit of a song. If I have any voice, I haven't sang a song in 3 years. So that's the way it is.
Where's my yoke on? There it is.
You have to, well, we sometimes rely on these thingies. Do you know what that is?
Capo.
Doc Watson called it a hillbilly chord arranger. A hillbilly chord arranger. I'll try a song, an Irish-American song. Came from some miners who built the Transcontinental Railway way back in the 1860s. They're called the Terriers. That was their nickname, the Terriers. And they're a hardy bunch of men, by all accounts. I knew a few of them myself. But I suppose they would have kept themselves entertained on the job with a song like this, where they make fun of the boss and his wife and the foreman and you name it. Everybody's fair game in this one. So I'll give it a go. We're going to get Paddy on the old drum here now. He's tuning it up. Very important to get that in the right key.
B minor, is it right?
I have a capo, he has a screwdriver. God be with the days when a power on just had a skin and that was it. I remember fellas in by the fire warming them up trying to get... And then you could get this electric warmer for the power on. It was a kind of a coil and you'd plug it in and leave it on top of the drum. And a fella, I remember one night, he left it on too long and it exploded.
I'm Paddy Boy.
Every morning at 7 o'clock, there's 20 terriers a-working on the rock. The boss comes round and he says, keep still, come down heavy on your cast iron drill, and drill ye terriers, drill. Drill ye terriers, drill. And it's work all day for the sugar in your tay, down beyond the railway, and drill ye terriers, drill. And blast and fire. The boss was a good man down to the ground. He married a woman who was 6 feet round. She baked good bread and she baked it well, but she baked it hard as the hops of hell. And drill ye terriers, drill. Drill ye terriers, drill. And it's work all day for the sugar in your tay. Blast went off a mile in the air when Big Tom Goff. And drill ye terriers, drill. Drill ye terriers, drill. And it's work all day for the sugar in your tay, down beyond the railway. And drill ye terriers, drill. And blast and fire. The next payday rolled around. Tom Goff, a dollar short, was found. He asked what for, came this reply: you were docked for the time you were up in the sky. And drill ye terriers, drill. Drill ye terriers, drill. And it's work all day for the sugar in your tay, down beyond the railway. And drill ye terriers, drill. And blast and fire. The next payday it rolled around. Tom Goff, a dollar short, was found. He asked what for, came this reply: you were docked for the time you were up in the sky. And drill ye terriers, drill. Drill ye terriers, drill. And it's work all day for the sugar in your tay. Sleep and work some more. We'll drill right through the day.
Fearghail's door and drill ye tarriers drill. Drill ye tarriers drill, and it's work all day for the sugar in your tay. Down beyond the railway and drill ye tarriers drill, and blast and fire. Every morning at 7 o'clock, there's 20 tarriers a-working on the rock. The boss comes round and he says, keep still. Come down heavy on your cast iron drill and drill ye tarriers drill. Drill ye tarriers drill, and it's work all day for the sugar in your tay. Down beyond the railway and drill ye tarriers drill, and blast and fire.
Going to get the man himself to strap on the pipes.
Keep him going anyway. That might be a little cold.
He's making up excuses already.
Sure, that's all we do, pipers. Either too hot or too cold. We'll try two tunes. The first one, I think I've heard it called Tom Busby's, I've never heard a recording of Tom Busby playing it. I think I might have heard it first from Harry Bradley on one of his albums. And the second tune then is actually from O'Neill's collection called I Know What You Like. Picked it out before all the COVID stuff, and yeah, just was browsing through O'Neill's and nice old tune. So I'll just tune these up and hopefully they'll be going grand. Wish me luck. That's not a good start.
To say there, I told my mother this morning I was heading up to the Seamus Ennis Art Centre. Well, she started telling me stories about Seamus Ennis. He came down to a party at my parents' house for a night and he stayed for 6 months. But he used to go into Donoghue's in Dublin there for his dinner, I think, every day. Maureen Donoghue used to have the dinner on for him. And when he was down with us, my mother used to make him the dinner. And he said to her one day, he said, Your mashed potatoes are far better than Maureen Donoghue's. Her potatoes are always lumpy. My mother still remembers it to this day.
Thank you.
Try another couple of reels, and these ones I usually play on the flute, but since I have the pipes strapped on, I'll play them on that anyway. Myself and Paddy did an album nearly 4 years ago, is it
that long?
Yes. I don't know.
And we still have about 22,000 CDs to sell, so if you want to help us out tonight, you're more than welcome.
We don't want them. three reels. The first one is called, or known as Jersey Commands, after concertina player from County Clare. Second one then is Paddy Sean Nancy's, or also known as Johnny Henry's, Johnny Watt Henry's. And then the last one then is called Miss Lyons. Miss Lyons is, so.
Lovely.
Three lovely tunes. Hope you like them anyway.
Thank you.
Thanks very much. I'm going to try a few myself this time on the fiddle, and Dónal might join me. Play two reels. The first one is a Connie O'Connell tune, a great fiddle player and composer. And he called it The Fire on Glen Ra. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right or not, but just close enough anyway. And the second tune is another Finbar tune, and he called it The Holly Bush. So I hope you enjoy these. Thank you. Thank you.
He's like an octopus, this man.
As if the pipes weren't bad enough.
I was thinking if we left all the instruments out on the stage, you would have thought the bothy band were coming on.
Myself and Donald are going to chance a couple of tunes, picking a couple of tunes on the guitar anyway. Give us a D there for a second. I suppose a couple of tunes. The first one's called The Fair-Haired Boy. I know I learnt it from the playing of Liam O'Flynn and Sean Keane and Matt Malloy on that album, The Fire of Flame. I think it was the third tune and the first track. not to be too specific, but the second tune then is called The Bank of Ireland. And then the last one is called Eggy White, I think, anyway. So that's where we're going, yeah. I'm not a real guitar player myself. Yeah.
Way out of that. He's been giving me a few lessons.
I can't even tune the thing.
Asher's grand. I'll cover for you.
Yeah, take me down in the mix.
Put on. Oh, jeez, don't do that.
Okay, right, hopefully we're grand.
Big round of applause there, Caoimhín on the guitar.
Yeah.
It's a new piece he composed.
Paddy might help us out on the drum.
I'll have to tune my bar on now for about 20 minutes.
Thank you.
we're not sure if we're okay for time. I think we're, our set list is about an hour and a half, but we were told earlier we should stop at an hour and a quarter. I don't know how what time we even started, but we'll keep playing until they turn off the lights. what have we? Okay. Three Wheels, the Dublin Lads, McGovern's, and what's the last one? Whose writing is that? Is that my writing? It's your writing, is it? Oh. It's actually my own. It's bad when you can't read your own writing, isn't it?
Tis one written by Joni Madden, wasn't it?
Oh, that's Joni Madden's tune, yeah. If she's watching, hi Joni. This is one of your tunes. Bring us on the cruise. This is called The Conspiracy. Or is it? We'll give it a go in here. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
much. We'll play another couple of tunes. The first one's known as Jenny Cronin's. What's that say? My eyesight is very bad now.
Five, is it?
Speak up.
Two sets. Two sets.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Too slow air, so.
Two long ones.
Yeah. What would you like? Any requests?
The song on hornpipes.
Yeah. What's your chances, Sam?
That's my chance, a quick little one. Yeah. Something happy and sprightly, I suppose.
It's a bit of Master McGregor or something.
Lovely.
I was singing a few songs. They had a night in Dungarvan there. For Seamus Power, the golfer. He's up to 45 in the world or something. He's a local lad down there, so they're having a night for him. And I don't know any sporting songs except one, and it's about another Waterford sporting hero. But a hero with four legs instead of two. It was Master McGrath. And there's a monument to Master McGrath out at his birthplace there, just outside Dungarvan. I won't say too much about it or I'll spoil the song, because it's all in there. Well, I suppose dog racing was the biggest sport back in those days. He won the Waterloo Cup three times, 1868, 69, and 70, I believe. In the date of the year, 'cause Waterloo sportsmen they all did appear to win the great prize and to bear it to war, never counting on Ireland and Master McGrath. On the 12th of December they left Irvine town, a gale in the channel it soon drove them down. On the 13th they landed on Fearghail shore. Those great English sportsmen they all gathered round, and one of those gentlemen gave a ha ha, saying, "Is that the great dog you call Master McGrath?" Lord Lurgan stepped forward and he said, "Gentlemen, are there any among you have money to spend? For your great English greyhound I don't care a straw, here's 5,000 to one upon Master McGrath." White Rose stood uncovered, the great English pride. Her owner and trainer, they stood by her side. They led her away and the crowd cried hurrah for the pride of all England and Master McGrath. The Rose and the Master, they both ran along. "I wonder," said Rose, "what took you from your home? You should have stayed there in your Irish domain and not come to gain laurels on Albion's plains." "It's true," said McGrath, "we have wild tether bogs, but you'll find in all Ireland we have good men and dogs. Lead on, Bower Britannia, give none of your jaw, stuff that up your nostrils," said Master McGrath. Oh, the hare she led on just as swift as the wind, he was sometimes before her and sometimes behind. Rose made the first turn according to law, but the second was given by Master McGrath. Oh, the hare she led on, what a beautiful view, as quick as the wind o'er the green field she flew. He jumped on her back and he held up his paw. "Three cheers for our Ireland," said Master McGrath. "I've known many dogs that have filled me with pride in the days that have gone, and it can't be denied. But the greatest and bravest the world ever saw was our champion of champions, Bower Master McGrath."
get 2 sets in. We try those jigs.
Yeah. Thanks very much. We might fit two sets in, would we? If you want. We can just finish up after this one if you want. We'll do a couple of jigs. First one's called Darby the Driver. I learnt it anyway from the playing of Mike Rafferty, great flute player from East Galway, who lived in the States for years. And the second one then is The Humours of Drina, or Drina, depends on where you're from, or which one is in question. There's a couple of them, I think. And then the last one is another one I learnt anyway myself from Mike Rafferty, called The Woods of the Green Fields of Woodford. Yeah. So we'll try these. very much. So we'll finish with this last one, couple of reels. So we'd like to thank everybody here at the Seamus Ennis Arts Centre for having us. To Shane and Phil on the sound. Am I right?
Yeah.
Thanks a million. And thank you all for coming out. It is great to do a proper gig again. Yeah, with people in front of you. I know there's people looking at screens as well, and hello to you all. Hope. But yeah, on my left here, Paddy Tutty. Give him a big round of applause. fiddle maker as well as fiddle player. If anyone's looking for to purchase a, you know, violin.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. And this is Dónal Clancy. I'm sure you know that.
Thank you.
Dónal has a couple of CDs, I think, as well. If anyone wants to, a couple of CDs.
I forgot to bring them out there. They're in the bag. In a bag somewhere.
But yeah.
So and that's Caoimhín Fearghail, the man himself. Big round of applause.
Yeah. So we might try these couple of reels. Jackie Fitzpatrick's, I think I got it from Dónal first. Some album, he was picking the tune on the guitar. And then Maud Miller, I think. And then Bonnie Ann, and then the Shaskeen to finish up. It's one of my favourite tunes anyway, the Shaskeens. And yeah, hope you enjoy and thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. Good night.